What are those things that will sell in the society? Mm-hmm. And besides, also use what you have to get what you want. I'm a unique being.
Okay.
And I looked at myself, okay, if I add more value mm-hmm. and offer a very good value, you know, presenting this nature mm-hmm. and allowing this nature to, you know, to execute that value.
Wow.
And talking about the value, good acting, good storyline, I mean, people would want to jump on it.
Wow. For those people that didn't have the privilege of growing up in really, really, really homes that they would be instilled those values,
mm-hmm.
but now they are all grown up
mm-hmm.
and they seem not to have a way forward or know what to do next to become self-confident,
mm-hmm.
what can they do?
Well, it depends on what you want, first thing first.
Okay.
Because no matter how there's this thing that drives home, that drives every individual.
Okay.
I mean, there's definitely going to be this moral thing in you
mm-hmm.
that can always tell you this is wrong and this is right. That can always give you some level of confidence. That mm-hmm. can only give you a guarantee that, look, you can do this
okay.
even when you tend to face some stumbling mm-hmm. blocks.
Mm-hmm.
When and such stumbling yeah. block is the self-esteem issues.
Yes.
I mean, there is that thing that you have in you that can always really help you, you know, come down to the reality that, look, it is about me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's not about
the
world.
Yeah.
It's about me.
Mm-hmm.
And the moment you take that bold step
mm.
to define what you want, I mean, it kicks off from there.
So basically all of this also starts from self-decision. You
yes.
have to make a decision.
Decision.
Wow.
And a very critical one for wow. that matter. Yeah.
Okay. How do you increase your self-worth for those that are already in the path?
Mm-hmm.
How would they continually increase it and grow in it and become very confident? Because the reason I'm talking so much about this is I discovered that the basics for success starts first with what you think about yourself. That's the identity
okay.
you have.
Okay.
So discovering yourself is a process.
Mm-hmm.
How do you continually build your self-esteem to become very, very impactful?
It is simple.
Okay.
One, we have for me. Okay, let me use myself as an example. Okay, in as much as I said I knew what I wanted, I knew they're the only thing that could help me break out of this particular lifestyle was mm-hmm. or this particular nature was having a very good education.
Mm-hmm.
But it did not end there.
Okay.
Okay. I had individuals who were inspiring.
Oh, okay.
I had individuals who I could look up to and tell myself that I would want to look like this person.
Okay.
I had individuals who are far more better, who are far way better than me
True.
In everything,
True.
Intellectually,
True.
Morally. And these were people I established relationship with.
Mm-hmm.
Because I said to myself, the moment you identify with positivity,
mm-hmm.
forget it, you will always grow in it.
Wow.
If you need to read just to acquire that thing you want.
Okay.
If you need to at least spend money to improve yourself, do it. All you need to do is, how can you improve yourself?
Okay.
Investment or relying on people to help you nurture and grow. Or any, just look for a way. What you think is best for you.
Wow.
That is just what I think it is.
Amazing. Amazing. So you have been very loud in the social media space lately. You've done a lot of stuff with... so many people,
mm-hmm.
the Kereku or
Kereku,
Mr. and Mrs. Kereku character or stories,
mm-hmm.
how did you discover it? Like, that's more like a trend now on social media.
Yeah,
a lot of people
yeah.
are watching it,
yeah.
really. And I see those views and I'm like, how did this guy come about this idea? Is this something you stumbled or is that a real life person?
the thing is, one... you look at your strength first.
Okay.
I studied theater art in the university.
Awesome.
Theater arts and media as well.
Okay.
I studied that and I knew, okay. And of course, I can classify to the fact that I'm a very good actor.
Mm-hmm.
And to an extent, even though I'm not a comedian, I do have some level of, I have a good sense of humor.
True.
You understand? And this is where my strength.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew that I can write as well
mm-hmm.
when it comes to putting up very naughty stories.
Yes.
And also look at the society. What are those things that will sell in the society?
Mm-hmm.
And besides, also use what you have to get what you want. I'm a unique being.
Okay.
And I looked at myself, okay, if I add more value mm-hmm. and offer a very good value,
mm-hmm.
you know, presenting this nature mm-hmm. and allowing this nature to, you know, to execute that value.
Wow.
And talking about the value, good acting, good storyline. I mean, people would want to jump on it.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. And those were my thoughts. And in the end, I just came up with that. Okay.
Wow.
Kirik, Mr. Minsky. And I thought about a very stupid name. Because if you, sorry for using the word stupid, but.
No, I get that.
The name, it's something I just coined. Mm-hmm. I just came up with. I didn't want to rely on the normal regular name, Mr. Mrs. Mbaka and all. Mm-hmm. You know, I wanted a name that does not exist.
Yeah, and the Kirikus, it looks smallish in nature.
Yes. A name that does not even exist.
Okay.
And that is how I just settled for Kirikou. Wow. Then I named it Mr. and Mrs. Kirikou.
Wow. So for people that are in situations and jobs, you know, different areas of life that are struggling to make people see their value, how can they begin to put the spotlight on themselves and how can they begin to put their value forward?
It depends on what spotlight you're trying to define.
Okay.
If you're referring to the media world, mm-hmm. if you're probably referring to other areas in life, mm-hmm. it depends on the area what you're trying to, the area of life where you find yourself.
Okay.
See, for me, okay, let me use a typical media world as an example. Mm-hmm. One, we have an existing, a growing social media platform right now.
True.
That is growing every day. Mm-hmm. We have the Facebook, we have the Instagram, we have the Twitter. We have massive platforms that you can define your world with. Uh-huh. You understand? Mm-hmm. And let me even start it off this way. When I started Mr. Mascarico, I only had about 3,000 blah blah followers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not trying to at least. I had 3,000 followers then. Mm-hmm. But the moment I offered a very good service, good content
mm-hmm.
to the few followers that you had, you see it spread.
Wow.
You see that networking start spreading.
Wow.
And that is what it is. Just define what you, as long as you're good at what you do,
mm-hmm.
as long as you're good at what you do, mm-hmm. in that little space, you tend to offer it.
Mm-hmm.
Keep doing it. I mean, out of nowhere, you see the lights, you know.
Begin to come. You know, because these days, a lot of people focus so much on, especially on social media, mm. followership,
mm. uh-huh.
gaining
uh-huh.
more followers uh-huh. and all of that. Some even go as far as doing the like for like mm-hmm. and all of those things. Mm-hmm. But you just made something very clear now that if you focus on a specific audience and mm-hmm. serve those audience, mm-hmm.
to spread out.
It will spread out.
Mm.
So why do you think young people are not getting that mindset of service?
Well, when you're referring, what bracket of young people are you referring to? Are you referring to the growing young people or to
growing young people? This is why I'm saying this because I've been in situations where you tell someone do this for me,
mm-hmm.
and the next thing they ask you is how much are you going to pay?
You won't blame them.
It's money. No focusing on the value. Why are young people not doing that?
You won't blame them. It is the society we live in.
Okay.
It has been the foundation.
Mm.
I mean, in as much as a lot of us do a lot of sacrificial activities, a mm-hmm. lot of, you know, we put in a lot of sacrifice just to see our mm-hmm. dream and then our visions come to light.
Mm-hmm.
You still won't blame people who would want to insist on asking for money.
Oh, okay.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
The society we live in, to an extent, can be frustrating.
Yeah.
You understand?
I agree.
Okay, look at it this way. You go through normal phases of attending schools and mm-hmm. graduating and you don't have a job. You understand? Then mm-hmm. you're so frustrated at home.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, and any little moment you have, you want to make something out of it.
Yeah.
So it is the society we live in.
Mm.
But then, in as much as we tend to find ourselves in this world as stirred up by our leaders, if mm-hmm. I rather, because mm-hmm. it's, as I said, it has been the foundation.
Yes,
it
yes.
is what they offer to us
that we are reaping.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. But in as much as we tend to find ourselves, I have successfully met people who have gone through the tough
times.
Moments to also define their world mm-hmm. as well, and you know, meet up with that demand, that vision, that dream they once had.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So if we can at least make such sacrifices.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, a lot of things would work, but still, it is still the society. Every individual defines his world the way he wants.
At the end of the day, it boils down to your self-decision.
Yes.
Amazing.
Hello everybody, my name is David Olatunji Arimide. I came here for event live streaming. Before I came down here, I have so many questions in my heart. How can I do this? How did they get this done? How to get very quality sound together with the video? All my questions were met. I have my applications already. So I have my facilitators as best of my friends that are even ready to even guide me period after today. It's been a very awesome and a wonderful one. I encourage you to also come and get a 2-day sharp training and become a boss of your own. Thank you.
Thank you so much for being on the show. Before we go, I don't know, what are your plans for the future? What should we expect from Mr. Kereku? what are the plans for that, and what are you planning to do?
I intend expanding on it.
Okay.
But of course, I would definitely would not want to rely just on that. I, at least in the long run, I intend at least having a very, at least for a startup, mm-hmm. a small media outfit for myself.
Oh, nice, nice.
They'll basically focus on documentaries and you know, movies.
Wow, amazing. So we should expect so much from you.
Yeah.
Amazing. Thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you very much for having me once again.
I really appreciate it. We look forward to having you again and again and again and
no
again.
No problem.
Amazing. All right, guys. You heard it from Victor Nwaugu himself talking about Mr. Kereku right here on the show. We talked about a couple of conversations, and I really do hope you learned a thing or two from our conversations today. Guys, you can follow us on all our social media platforms, on YouTube, on Instagram, on Facebook. And of course, you can also follow Kubi Official on Instagram and of course on Facebook and a lot of other platforms out there. So we'll come your way again, same time, same station. Have an amazing one. God bless you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.